Let me see. In addition, teachers will use collages, newspaper and magazine articles. I think this is one word. Newspaper and magazine articles along with art projects where... Oops. Student will cut words out of magazines. So we say, so they would cut words out of magazines to make what? Okay, good to make. This is good stuff. Oops. STORY. Oops. Okay, I think this might actually help to fill the two pages. Let me see. So, in addition, teachers will use collages, newspaper, and magazine articles, along with art projects where students will cut words out of magazines to make a story. Okay, I'm loving it.
Okay.
Is it raining where you are?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you hear that thunder?
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, me too.
Okay.
Let's see, in previous work of the introduction, wait, what the hell?
Okay, so now so he told me, I copy and pasted from my previous introduction.
Okay.
He told me to, you know, so... It was like, I kind of understand it now, like, talk about what you saw in your student teaching. Now, related to the textbook, now related to your previous work in last semester. And down on the bottom, that's how I did it. I separated it, but that's how I did it, if you could see it.
Let me see. So, in the previous work of the entry, do you need to say that? So maybe you could just start at writing is important because it helps people.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is from last semester. I was just, he told me with the tutor to like change it around.
Okay. So writing is important because it helps. So let's change from people to students. S-T-U-D-E-N-T. Students to express themselves.
My previous work because I want him to know this is from like, or he doesn't need to.
I don't,
because he told me to use like chapter 1, chapter 2, like to use that, not chapter, like what we did in the previous work.
So, but you, is it necessary that you say that this was from your previous work though?
I don't think so. No, I don't know.
Okay, let's try and get through this real quick and then we'll see. So writing is important because it helps students to express themselves. Unfortunately, writing can also be a difficult and demanding task. Writing is a self-directed activity involving. So right, so that second sentence that needs a little more explanation. So when you say unfortunately writing can also be a difficult and demanding task, so why is writing a difficult and demanding task?
Writing, because as you're a writing tutor, you don't find it difficult?
When I was in the fourth grade, I think it was, or the third grade, it might have been the second grade, I found writing difficult because my teachers were pretty much dumbasses. They didn't really know how to teach. Like, for me, writing is not difficult, and since I've been practicing it, I figured out ways to show you and other people when you listen to me that writing isn't a difficult and demanding task. Why isn't writing a difficult and demanding task? And I've experimented on people from 10 years old to 80 years old that I've worked with, because writing only requires you to consider who, what, when, where, how, and why. Once you do that, once you understand who are you talking about or who do you want to talk about, so the who can be you or an author or a person. You could be somebody on television. It could be somebody. It could be you. It could be your parents. It could be a friend. And then what do you want to say about them? So that who and the what, that's what makes writing very easy. That's what makes writing the most easy thing, that because you know who, you know what, you know when, where, how, and why. You know all this stuff. And then writing is also about giving your opinion about who, what, when, where, how, and why. And then writing is also about raising questions about you. So when you say, why is unfortunately writing difficult and demanding? So you have to assert that to yourself. So why is, and who? So you're the who. Why is writing difficult for me? But why isn't writing difficult for other people?
So far, I've been working with students about like 2 years now. First grade, third grade. And third grade is very difficult.
Like, so, why is it difficult though? Why is it difficult?
It's hard for them to stay on the topic, and it's hard for them to process ideas and to write it down.
Right. But in my experience, so if you took the kid to New Jersey and you asked the kid to go home, it would be difficult, right?
Because they're young. They don't know the way.
That's my exact point. But if you keep taking the kid to New Jersey and showing the kid how to come home, even though they're young and they don't know the way, they will learn the way, because that's just the way the human brain works. Mm. Makes sense? Exactly. Or practice that they have in school. Because as I said, writing for me when I was in the third grade, it was difficult because my teachers were assholes. They didn't know how to teach, okay? Probably because nobody taught them how to teach. I used to see other people writing, but I'm like, what the hell are they writing about? Because I couldn't think of what to write about. But I would try and make believe I'm writing, but my teacher actually stayed to see if I'm writing anything. Me, I would have stayed to make sure that student wrote something, and then I would have just told them what to write. But the teacher didn't do that. That's why they're assholes. You know, and it may be because they just weren't taught to do it. Or maybe they just assholes. You don't know the circumstances. But the thing is, it's that if you're shown how to do something, if you're taken to New Jersey, no matter how old you are, you know, enough times, you're going to know how to get home after a while. You know, you're going to know what train or bus to take, or what route to ride your bike or to walk. Because that's just the way the human brain works. But if you don't practice it, you won't improve. So me, again, writing was very difficult for me because nobody showed me how easy it really is. So writing is who, what, when, where, how, and why. Writing is saying, how many fingers do I have? And then you write, I have 5 fingers. That's all, you know, on one hand. And I have 5 fingers on my right hand and 5 fingers on my left hand. So imagine writing that. Imagine if you told a student to write that. So that's all writing is, though. So, right, and if I'm reading this first sentence, so if I read this, writing is important because it helps students to express themselves. And if I ask a student, so what does that first sentence say? So, the student's going to read it and say, when the student reads it, they're going to read, writing is important because it helps students to express themselves. Then I say, so write what that says. And the student's going to write, writing is important because it helps students express themselves. See, the thing is, once you know how to read, you know how to write. Okay? And then if it's right there in front of you, the words are right there in front of you. So you could say, write those words. Just write that sentence for sentence. And then you could say, so what's your opinion for that? You know, with that, do you agree or do you disagree that writing is important because it helps students express themselves? So then that student's going to say, I either agree with it, I don't agree with it, or I don't know. I don't have enough experience. So, but it's the writing process. You know what I mean? And, so if you don't do that with a student, because I get college students all the time that I have to show them that come from other countries, and they're not, you know, like you, and I have to show you how to write. And then I see them picking it up. You know, they can't do it on their own because they don't speak English. But then when I show them, they pick it up. Just like your writing has improved, you know, and I see other people. Yes. I told you that no, not last week, but the week before. Remember when I told you that how, because I, you know, when you used, it looked like computer code when you used to write, you know? I didn't know what the hell you were saying. I didn't know what you, yeah, I had no clue as to what you were saying.
But you act like you did.
Yeah, because I didn't want to hurt your feelings at the time and build your confidence.
Can you just get to the fucking point, bro?
Yeah, that's, you know, that's... That's important because we don't have a lot of time, you know. So because, yeah. So and I was trying to get you to be more efficient, but it's like it's the same thing I tell everybody. There's no thinking required here. You read, you use the reading material from the class because this is a different genre of writing, and but you have to use the who, what, when, where, how, and why.
Yeah.
To help direct you. In reading this stuff. So if you were to write about your life, if I would say, so write about this time that we're working on this, you know what, you know, I mean, you were here, you're here, you know what happened, you know, so we started at this time, we went over this, we began at the beginning of the essay, and we did this at this time, you know, somebody went to the restroom, somebody took a swig of alcohol, something happened though. You know, that's all writing is. Just what do you know? You know, what's your name? Where do you live? That's writing. All of that. But then the same thing, when you read, what are you reading, though? Just say, you know, what is the author telling you? The same way you would write about, what am I telling you? You know, what did your mother tell you? What did your husband tell you? You know, what are your what family members? That's all writing is. It's basically regurgitating information. And then you could write about your opinion. That's all it is. So unfortunately, writing can also be difficult and a demanding task. So we need to add something there. And I would say if we do not practice on a regular basis. Right. So it's difficult and demanding. Again, you know, I mean, if somebody took you to, what, New Zealand, you know, and they said, well, find the capital of New Zealand. And how the hell are you going to find the capital of New Zealand? You've never been there before, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right,
yeah,
so, right, but if you've been to the, right,
yeah.
You know, so.
So it's like lack of practice, but like what you showed me is like, kind of made like reading, it's still a little difficult for me, but you made reading for me a little easy because I go and I'd be like, you know what, he's telling me to take quotes from it, he's telling me there's nothing to think, just think about it, take words and explain it to it, and that's what I did with that, and so far he said it was okay, but I had to like change those two paragraphs around. You know?
Right. Yeah, no, what he's looking for, what the professor's looking for is more detail. That's all you're missing here. You're missing the detail, and that's all I'm adding. I'm just adding detail, some in terms of words, to make it more,
yeah.
How would you say?
So we could take out writing is important because it helps students express themselves. We could take that out, right?
I don't see anything wrong with it.
It's good like that? Or we could move it around?
I think it's... I like it because it's positive. So
okay.
I think you should always try and start with something positive. So, and then the next one, unfortunately, writing can also be difficult and demanding, can also be a difficult and demanding task if we do not practice on a regular basis. Right. Because even if you learn to write and read, if you don't constantly practice it, you'll get worse at it. You don't stay at the same level. Okay? So, right. So that's why you have to constantly practice it. So, okay, so let's go on to the next sentence, which is, writing is a self-directed activity involving the use of a variety of strategies and skills to satisfy the writer's goals and meet the needs of the reader. Okay, I like that. Let me see, students who may have difficulty speaking could find it easier to write, allowing them another way to communicate. Okay, that's good. This is the first step for many students in discovering their voice. Let's see, knowing how to write is a necessary skill students need. Why is there a blue line under there? Is a necessary skill. Let me just see what's going on. It's a necessary skill student. That's a skilled student need. No, that's incorrect. I'm looking at the corrections. It's necessary skills students need. I don't know what the hell that computer's thinking about. In order to communicate their thoughts on paper to their teachers and others. Okay, that's perfect. How the hell is this perfect all of a sudden? Let me see. Many students learn to write from an early age.
That was my previous thing. I got help in last semester.
Okay, so most children start with the alphabet. As they progress, they work their way. So the professor wants you to change this around?
Like change the whole two, because that was my previous work.
The professor saw this?
Yeah, he told me you have to change it around. It's good, but I have to change it around. It's like you said, more detail.
Okay, students who may have difficulty speaking, get easier to write, allowing them to. Let's see. What if you say students? Let's get the negatives out. So let's get rid of difficulty. And let's say students will find it easier to write when they, they have been given. Let me see, am I spelling that? Why the hell do I keep spelling this incorrectly? Given proper instruction. In what to focus on. Okay, good. Let me see. So students will find it easier to write when they have been given proper instruction in what to focus on. Communicate. Let me see. I kind of like this. I'm wondering if you, what if you say students can. So, or children, let's see, children, can use writing as another way to communicate their thoughts and desires. Thoughts. Let me see. Did I spell thoughts correctly? Your thoughts and desires. About. T-H-E there. Environment. Let me see. Did I spell that right? Okay, good. I think I spelled that right. It looks good. This is the first step for many students in discovering their voice. Let me see. So,
maybe I was thinking to just put a voice put in the beginning. Like, this is a way, like, for writing. Like, how this is a way for students to express their voice, to express their writing. Like, express it on paper.
Many. We'll see. There are many formats that can be adopted for a child. Let's get rid of this. Adopted for a CHILD. Oops. For a child to backspace voice.
Oh, it's raining.
T-H-E there. Oh. Okay, I think so. There are many formats that can be adopted for a child to voice their opinion. Let's see. I don't like that. Knowing how to write is a necessary skill students need in order to communicate their thoughts on paper. Let me see. What if you just say writing skills? WRIT, writing. What the hell is that G? Writing skills. Are needed. Needed. To communicate. Let's get rid of in order to. To communicate. On paper. Let's get rid of thoughts, because we have thoughts above. Okay, on paper. With others. Paper. With. Ah, it's a little too close, though. The writing skills I need to communicate on paper. On paper. In a student's future. What if we say success? I think that's how you spell success. Okay, let me see. Writing skills are needed to communicate on paper for, not in a student's success, for a student's success. For a student's. Oops. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Many students learn to write from an early age. Most. Oh, right. So. Instead of. Let's say most people. Most.
People learn, maybe?
So, most people learn to write. What?
But in general, most people learn.
No, this is pretty much the same thing. Most people learn to write from an early age. So what if you say, what age is that though? Can you be specific? Mm-hmm. Like first grade or something? Say most people learn to write. At.
Most people start writing maybe first grade, second grade?
Yeah, I think that's when I began to write at. Oh, so, wait, we can change that to in the first grade. In. Okay, right. In the. FIRST. GRADE. Let's get rid of that. Most children start with the alphabet. As they progress, they work their way up to sentences, paragraphs, and essays. Being able to, so, to write well, skill that goes. Okay, I think we can leave that second sentence. As they progress, they work their way up to sentences. So here, I think we might, so, most,
as. We can take that out.
Why?
Most children start with the alphabet.
Why?
I don't know.
I think it's okay. Most children start with the alphabet. I would say, and just end.
Instead of saying
maybe you can say children instead of most children. Let's see. So children start with the alphabet and learn. Let me see. What the hell am I in learning? And learn how to. I think that was my two things. Learning how to write my name and the alphabet and learn how to write D-H-E-I-R and A-M-E-S. Right, so that should be good. Progress their work. So when you say as they progress, THROUG through. What if you say sub sub Q quint M see, did I spell that correctly? No, it was an I-E instead of an I, as it goes to subsequent GRE grade levels. Their way up to sentences, paragraphs, and essays. And essays is a life skill that goes beyond. So let's change this to, instead of being able to write, so writing, we'll just start at writing well. W-R-I-T-I-N, writing well is a life skill that goes beyond school. Let me see grade levels soon. As they progress through subsequent grade levels, they work their way. Why the hell is that thing bothering me with the little S? Writing well is a life skill that goes beyond school. Most people need to be able to write well. That goes beyond school. Let's see, most people. Let's see. What if you say we? Or everyone. Let's see. Everyone needs to. Let's get rid of be able. So try not to use being or be able. Everyone needs to know how to. Everyone needs to know how to write well. To teach others who to teach. Actually, I don't know, I wonder if this is a little so what else can you add something from your readings? You know, can you add something from the, everyone needs to know how to write well to teach others how? You with me?
Yeah.
So you, I don't, you don't look like you're looking at your readings. So what is,
no,
what?
No, I am. I'm reading. Well, I'm seeing what you're doing. I saw your thing. Everyone needs to know how to write well. So you have to add something here, right?
Yeah. If you could find something in the reading that talks about why it's good for people to write well, or not even just talk, just or something about writing. Everyone needs to know how to write well.
Hold on.
As, okay. Yeah. I'm holding. I'm not going anywhere.
Society. Can you tell me why it's so important? Why it's so important people need to learn how to write well?
You want me to explain that to you?
Yeah, because I have something, but I'm not too sure.
Okay, so let's share yours then, and then we'll see. Oh, wait. Hold on a second. damn it. You're a lot of work, you know?
Huh?
You're a lot of work.
Why? I just sent you a quote I got from the reading.
Read it?
Read that, or I could just tell you.
Yeah, tell me.
I'm a lot of work?
Yeah.
Hey, you must miss me last week.
Well, we don't have time to go into that right now, so read the quote.
I sent it to you on email. Okay, so hold it. There are helpful benefits, but at the end, did you read the email or you want me to just read it to you?
Read it.
Okay, not all of it, but I like this one. So, previously published review articles are very useful to planning a new literature review because they are helpful in identifying the scope of literature field of study. So, I was thinking from that, it's like you know how we do articles, paragraphs, and all that. For them to read, for them to practice. I think this is really good because it's a useful source.
Okay.
Because now you always tell me, look, read some stuff, do this, read, look at some words and words that you don't know. So that's what I try to do. Can you look at? I try to throw like big words in there.
Right.
I use articles what I read. From there. So I think that's useful because one time when one of my students, when I told them, all right, you know what, let's read something and that's how we're going to start writing.
Right.
So they write something, I'm like, okay, now take a quote and explain it to me, what the article says. Explain to me in your own words. Read it when they read it. So that's helpful.
Yes. Let's see. Okay. I was just, while you were saying that, I was just looking at some of the other stuff that you have. Writing well is a life skill that goes beyond school. Everyone needs to know how to write well as a means to improve society, to teach, and to teach others how, for words, teach others who